Hey guys, it's Putty from the Russified Official Servers here with a quick overview of this Thursday's update. First off, you don't have to be rich in-game to enjoy automated base defense anymore. The team has added in a new shotgun trap. This trap is basically the poor man's turret. The trap only uses handmade shells and has a firing rate of 1 shot per second. It currently can be placed on a variety of different surfaces in your base, including the ceiling, but this could be subject to change in the not-too-distant future. These traps work in a similar manner to the flame turret. Authorization is based on a tool cupboard that has the trap within its range. But unlike the flame turret, these traps do not sway, so placement is very important. Oh, and the best part about this new trap is its cost. It will set you back 1,000 wood, 250 metal frags, 1 rope, 1 gear, and has 200 HP. Furnace bases have gotten a lot more interesting. You can now place floor grills above large furnaces. This should make it a lot easier to protect your raw materials from furnace bandits and make furnace bases a little cheaper to construct. Just remember that destroying the floor grills only costs 1C4. Floor spikes now impede the placement of foundations, so if you need a fast solution to people building up, you can pop these down. Just remember that they don't have a lot of health. Speaking of placed twig, you'll now be seeing a lot less of it after this update, as the 2-hour decay rate now applies to all twig pieces and not just the foundations. This should help clean up some of the entity counts on servers. An entity memory leak has been fixed, an issue causing an extra 25 to 35k entities on high pop servers has been corrected. Although this didn't have a large impact on game performance, it will fix some minor issues with prefabs not being correctly destroyed when items would combine or animals ate things. Hear that? Reddit users should be happy, the old Rust music will be finally making its way back into the game. This won't be happening this update, but should be happening in the next couple of weeks. That's a summary of the significant changes coming to Rust this week. I'm Putty, and thanks for watching. If you want to know more about this update or any other update, subscribe to the channel or head over to Rustified.com, and don't forget to check us out on the Rustified official servers.